وعلى أصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين اللهم لنا ذنوبنا واصلح أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. I'm very impressed, تبارك الله, by this evening. MashaAllah, very well organized. Thank you very much for the organizers. I really like this. Also, I would like to remind all of you that these circles and meetings and things, according to my recollection, they've been going for the past at least 20 or 21 years. Still, we have the brothers who I met in 1996 at Fulham Road Mosques organizing these programs. These Friday circles continued for a number of years, 20 years as I recollect. So, mashallah, tabarakallah, this is an amazing meeting, and I hope that it continues, and you continue as well to support this work, because this is the real spirit of the youth in Europe. This is why people are here in Europe. Europe is not going to collapse. We are not going to go out, because we are part of the fabric of the society. Anybody tells you that the Muslims are going to leave, they're leaving, this is wrong. Because we are here, 14 million people in Europe, and we should really support and be vehemently behind the European project, the European Union and the single market. We have to be right behind it, right left and center, very, very important, because this is who we are. We would like to, we support freedom of movement of personnel, we support freedom of movement of items, we support freedom of movement of services, and we support us going from one place to the other. Nobody can stop us. All around 28 countries. Imagine, 500 million population in Europe. That's 500 million. If we pull it from Europe, we will be what? We will be 60 million. And Scotland leaves, Wales leaves, Ireland leave. Then we will be left only England, which is... at all. So mashallah tabarakallah, you have to be very, very proud of who you are. You've been here for a very, very long time. Your fathers have been here, maybe your generation before has been here. And the da'wah in this country has been going for the past, at least from the 1950s. At least from the 1950s. So you did not just come in from the crack of the wall, out of nowhere. No, there is you've got very, very strong and very heavy roots as well, going really down to the ground in Europe. This is where you are, this is where you belong, and this is inshallah where you stay. This is the da'wah of La ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah, a European da'wah. A European da'wah, nothing to do with anything else. We are not Arabs or Pakistanis or Bengalis. We are Muslims, we are European Muslims. This is a very, very important message, and we have to understand it. Moving into the topic of today, which is Surah Al-Asr. SubhanAllah, I don't know who has chosen this Muslim Ummah plan, strategic plan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the strategic plan for the Muslim Ummah in this little surah, one of the smallest surahs in the world. What is the smallest surah in the Quran? Here is the smallest surah in the Quran. Wal-Asr innal insana lafi khusr. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Wal-Asr innal insana lafi khusr. Illa alladhina amanu wa 'amilus salihati wa tawassaw bil haqqi wa tawassaw bis sabr. You know, this is who we are. This is who we are. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting for us a triangle to work on. This is our strategic plan, and this is our mission statement. Wal-Asr innal insana lafi khusr. Wal-Asr, what asr? I swear by the ages, not just one age, but by the ages, by the nations, by the Umam and the nations that came before us. The Umam of Sayyidina Salih. Thank you. Abdullah said, Ya Rasulullah, let me go and tell this da'wah to, let me go and outcry with this da'wah to the leaders and the bosses of Quraysh. And the Prophet, he was absolutely, how is he going to do this? He went and he said, Wallahi, you have to believe. What pushed him? This iman that pushed him. This thing is inside himself that pushed him. Sayyidina Bilal, when he believed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq went to Bilal. In the middle of the night, he said, Ya Bilal, is it not time for you to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? One of the masters of Quraysh, one of the richest men in Quraysh, a tradesman, how did he find the time to go and make da'wah? He went to Bilal and he said, Ya Bilal, is it not time for you? Is it not time for you to become part of this da'wah, to become part of this group, Ya Bilal? And Bilal said, Ya Abu Bakr, is it not any other time? Tomorrow, inshallah. He said, how do I guarantee that we will be alive tomorrow? How do I guarantee that? This is the faith that in people's hearts. This is the seedling that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as soon as faith comes into the heart, it cleanses it and links it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As soon as faith comes into your heart, you feel that you're linked to a superpower, to the mightiest of the mighties, to the strongest of all kings and princes. You're linked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You feel very, very confident. You feel full of yourself. You feel really, really as well at the same time, humble and modest. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the follower of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh my God. Just a little iota on earth. Just a little grain on earth that follows this mighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you are one of the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A slave of Allah. It's an address. It's a very, very high address. It's an address of very high dignity. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Abdullah. He said, Subhan alladhi asra bi'abdihi. Glorify, this is Surah Al-Isra. Glorify him subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who took his slave. The ulama say, Subhan alladhi asra bi'abdihi. This hat, they call this is hat in Tashreef. Tashreef is to honor the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah azza wa jal made him his slave. Huh? And a woman in Islam is called Amatullah. So many of our sisters are called Amatullah, isn't it? They're called Amatullah. That means she's the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an honor to be a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we are not slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we'll be slaves of somebody else. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ta'isa abdu dirham, ta'isa abdu dinar, ta'isa abdu qatifa, ta'isa man takasa, wa idha shita falan taqash. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, those people who worship their lives are the slaves of their life. You are slave to your wealth, you are slave to your health, you are slave to your money, you are slave to your bank account. Better to be slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the message that Sayyidina Rabi'i ibn Amr said to the king of the Persians. You know, Persia at that time was like Russia today. Persia and the Roman Empire, the Indians, the Chinese, they were the superpowers of that particular time. And imagine how the Muslims from nobody, from just one person, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, into a massive, huge group of people, into a massive, huge army that goes and threaten the Persian Empire. How dare you? This is unheard of. How can this happen? Rabi ibn Amr, he said, the Kisra, the king of the Persians, said, bring one of them, let us see them. So Rabi ibn Amr came in with his leather sandals, with his shabby clothes, with his horse. The horse is like, you know, hardly has a saddle on its back. And he comes in with his shabby clothes and things, and he looks absolutely like, you know, dusted. He just came from the war. He comes in a place like that. Look, if you enter the Persian castle now, subhanAllah, it's like one of these huge, it's like a Versailles castle in Paris, in France. He enters this huge court, and he says, what brought you in? What brought you? And Sayyidina Rabi'i ibn Amr, he did not fear all these weapons and spears and hardware. He did not fear all this army around him. He did not fear all these gold and ornaments and beautification and the rest of it. He did not fear those people who looked really, really beautiful and pretty. And he did not look, he did not fear anything. He just came in and he tied his horse to the carpet. You see the Persian carpet, they've got bustles at the end. He tied his horse and he walked along to the king and with his spear, with his spear, and he went and he said, "What brought you in? Maladhi akhrajakum?" Very derogatory statement. What brought you out? That means you're secluded there, you're thrown behind the nations, you're nobodies, you're barefooted camel drivers. What brought you out? You've been there for a very, very long time. Nobody even thinks about you. What brought you out? Maladhi akhrajakum? What brought you out? He said, "What, you want some money? You want some things? We'll provide that, no problem." He said, "Maladhi akhrajana?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took us out from there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us all this way, from there to here, to give you the message of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. This is the pure, this is the pure slavery of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the pure slavery of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the sweetness of Iman, that you don't even fear who is in front of you. He said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us in to take whoever He wishes from the worship of the slaves to the worship of the lord of the slaves. And from tightness of life to the openness of the Akhirah. Same thing happened with Sayyiduna Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, the Egyptian faqih and imam, when he saw the king the king of Egypt, and he said to him, at that time they were ruled by these, and he said, "How is it you standing here in a Muslim empire where people are drinking alcohol there?" Everybody thought that this man is going to kill him. Everybody thought that the king is going to kill Sayyidina Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam. But he didn't touch him. He didn't say anything. He said, "I will look into him." When he went back, and he met his students, he said, "How did you feel?" He said, "Wallahi, I felt like he is like a mouse. Wallahi, I felt like he's a kitten. I had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala filled my chest with Iman and with his strength." This is the sweetness of Iman. It's when you feel confident about something. It's when you feel that you are part of a huge, massive convoy that started from Sayyiduna Adam to Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and continues here to Europe. You are the messengers of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of Surah Yusuf that قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي. That's why our brothers, whether in the Indian subcontinent, whether in the Arab world, this is a logo for them. قُلْ. Says قُلْ. It says قُلْ. They refer to what? They refer to this particular ayah, which is قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي. And another people had this logo which says هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي. On top there is قُلْ, then هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي. So very, very nice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي. Ya Muhammad, this is at the end of Surah Yusuf, last page. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ya Muhammad, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي." This is my path. This is my life. I dedicate my life to this thing. I am there on the path. I want nothing without this path. Absolutely nothing. Nobody, I am nobody without this path. I am this path and this path is me. I am this da'wah and the da'wah is me. I am the direct reincarnation of this da'wah. Without it, I am absolutely nothing, nobody. I'm just living like a UFO. But this da'wah is who I am. This is how I manifest myself to the people around me. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ. Say, "Ya Muhammad, this is my path." أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. I call to Allah عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ. With a defined insight, i.e. I know what I'm doing. I'm not a wimp. I'm not a bozo. I'm not a wazok. No, I know what I'm doing. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ. Some of our brothers, they open the Mus'ab and they call their sons and daughters And somebody opened the Mus'haf and he said, Basira. I said, I'll call my daughter Basira. He says, brother, you don't call yours. It's different. It's like calling your daughter Specsavers. On a definite, in, I know very, very well what I'm doing. I am not out of this world. I know what I'm doing. I and those people who are behind me. Not just me. Why does he say that the Prophet said, not just me? Because the Prophet spent 23 years giving tarbiyah to the masters of humanity. This is a very important thing. And Sayyidina Al-Mahdawi talked about this very, very well. And Sayyidina, the dean of the university in Lucknow, what's his name? Imad al-Kathir al-Alam of the Muslimin. Abu al-Hasan al-Adawi. He said that the leadership in Islam is an educated leadership. When the leader comes in, he is the product of the Tabi'ah 14 years ago. He knows very well what he's doing. He does not distinguish between races. There's no supremacy in the race. He knows very well. He knows very, very well that justice is what makes and breaks. So he doesn't differentiate between people. And the adlu al-mulk, justice is the foundation of your kingdom. Without it, you disappear. That's why Sayyidina Ibn Taymiyyah said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supports the kafir state if they are just, and does not support the Muslim state if they are unjust. Can you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is tolerating the West? Despite the fact that they're kuffar, because they are just. And if you want to see how they are just and how they are fair, take your wife to any hospital while she's giving birth to see how they treat her like little girl. It's an amazing thing. Go to the court and you will see how the judge is going to give you what you want. You're black, you're white, you're red, and yellow, doesn't matter. This is what makes them great. So this is the first point, which is Iman. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Everybody is in total loss, apart from those who are Aman. Iman holds our hearts and pushes us to do things. Now what is the direct, what is the byproduct of Iman? What is the byproduct of Iman? And the first result of Iman, what does it yield? Yield, Iman yields إِلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Iman yields al-amal al-salih. If we have Iman without amal al-salih, then we've got a sword that we're keeping at home. Everybody comes in and says, oh my God, then I brought this beautiful little sword. Oh, you want to have it? If you have a sword, then you have to use it. And if you have a sword, you have to know how to use it. What is the use? If you don't know how to use it, it's not use. It's useless. If you have a car and you just put it in there, a classic car that is 100 years ago, 100 years ago, what's the difference of that car? Well, Al Capone was shot in it. Oh my goodness, I don't want to say it. You know something? We kept the people modify their Iman. People modify their Iman. They say that my Qibla is in my heart. And my Iman is in my chest. And I don't hurt anybody. And I don't want anybody to hurt me. I have to take in that corner so that I die. I'm very much to sit there. I don't want to see you anymore. Because he is useless to the society, to the community. Rasulullah said, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best amongst you are the good ones who to the community.
saw the NHS being sold to the rich people. He saw the country is being owned by a few people who can afford and do not pay taxes. This is injustice that we have to fight. Otherwise, we are not going to be able to do it. When I see something wrong, we have to address it. When I see somebody like Jerry Corbyn shouting and screaming and saying, listen, this is wrong.
Spend your money here as well. Spend outside and spend your money here as well. This is the Amal, this is the Amal Saleh. If you join a group, a movement like this one, this is the Amal Saleh. This is a very, very good thing because we need to do things together. We cannot do things, we cannot do one thing only. We need to do things together. By himself. تواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. That means they advise each other to adhere, advise each other to be patient, to uphold the حق, حراسوا الحق, to look after the حق. Like for example, now this. This, mashallah, tabarakallah, this move is an amazing thing. This is from tawasul al-haqq wa tawasul al-sabr. Problems, I've got problems. I will pour my heart to you. You will pour your heart to me. But we will adhere together to do one thing. It's an amazing thing when people join in a jama'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed good and projected and prevented by a jama'ah. He formed a jama'ah. As soon as he came in, he formed a jama'ah of people together, to work together. Today we need to do things together. Today we need to pray together. That's why you will say, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَقِيمُ الزَّكَاةَ, i.e. together, in the plural form, not in the singular form. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, أَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ, he said, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَقِيمُ الزَّكَاةَ وَاعْتَصِمُ بِاللَّهِ. He always addressed the jama'ah. He always addressed the people around him. This is a very, very important thing because upholding the truth is a very difficult thing. And nobody can do this by ourselves. We have to be a group of people in order that we discharge responsibility and address the need. It's a very important thing, especially at this moment in time when Islam is in the question. You see Islam everywhere, you know why? Because it's a very important deen, it's a very important faith. Do not feel squeamish or irritated when you see Islam is all the time in the news. It's a very good publicity to Islam, by the way. It's a very good to be in the news, negative or positive. But it's bad if you're not in the news. This is a marketing principle. It's good to be in the news, positive or negative. But do not be not in the news, because this is not good. When you are bad in the news, when you go, you do good in the news, people will go and follow you. You will always address in a nasty way, just like Jeremy Corbyn, because he is upholding the truth. He doesn't want to privatize his country. He doesn't want the country to be sold to the rich people. He doesn't want the foreign investors to buy chunks of his country and Netflix. He doesn't want people like Richard Branson and others to go and live in the Bahamas and not pay taxes in here because they are non domiciled. No, he wants people to be here, not to be somewhere else. This is a very, very important thing. So to be in the news is very, very good, positive or negative. But not to be in the news is a very, very negative thing. But don't think that this attack on Islam is bad. No. People who are attacked are the successful people. Who attacks the failure? When you get stabbed in the back, that means you are in the front. Otherwise, nobody can stab you in the back. People will stab you from the front. But when you are in the front, people will stab you from the back. It's a very important thing. The other thing is, look where the arrows of the enemy going. Follow the arrows of the enemy because it finds what good and what bad. Who attacks? Who attacks a failure? Who attacks a nobody? People who are attacked are the ones who are successful, who are doing very, very well. But on our behalf, we need to be, this is a very good initiative, and this has been going for a very, very long time. Hold on tight to this. This is the last one we have to do. Because life is very, very bitter, and things are really, really difficult. And the going is getting very tough. But you have to understand it's only the tough gets going. When the going gets tough, only the tough gets going. Not everybody. This is not for the faint hearted. This is for people who understand. For people who know what is going on. Be always with the truth and with the people who uphold the truth. Do not be with the people who are they build shrines and they are introverted. They're very insular. Be with the people who are in the mosques, people who are outwardly looking, people who are, they don't fear to speak their mind. With the people who are looking forward. It's a very, very important thing. This ayah, this surah, Sayyidina Imam Shafi'i radiallahu anhu said, this is the surah al-Muslima. This is a fusion for the Muslim Ummah. This is a strategic mission for the Ummah Muslimata to believe and to do good and to adhere amongst themselves in order that we hold up all the truth and do harasul haq. Harasul haq means